Hi, this presentation is going to consider some basic concepts of probability. And one of the central features of this discussion will be probability experiments, which is just any action through which specific results, whatever they may be, are obtained. So rolling a die, for instance, can result in a particular outcome. Observing the number that is rolled, therefore, is a probability experiment. And so we have another term here, which is trial, which would be the number of times we conduct the experiment. So if we roll a die one time, that's a single trial. And of course, the outcome, the number that comes up, and the set of all possible outcomes is what we're going to call the sample space. So in terms of a die, that'd be 1 through 6. Those are all the possible outcomes. So an event can consist of more than one outcome. We may want to know, for instance, the probability of rolling a 4 2 times in a row. And that would be an event, but would consist of two outcomes, two numbers coming up. So event A is rolling an even number, for example. And a simple event is one that consists of a single outcome. Of course, the more times you roll the die, the more complex it gets, such as rolling a die 3 times and expecting to get a 2, 4, and 6. Next, we can talk about classical probability, which is used when the outcome is equal, where it doesn't change. So the probability of an event is, therefore, just simply the number of outcomes, an event, divided by the total number of outcomes in the sample space. So if you have 6 possible outcomes in the sample space from rolling a die, the number of outcomes in an event, such as rolling any of the individual numbers, such as a 3, would be 1 over 6, because 3 is only one of the possible 6 outcomes. While classical probability is theoretical, we have another concept here of empirical probability, which is what we observe. And so we can collect data by perhaps rolling a die repeatedly and seeing what the outcomes are and recording those. So frequency of event over the total frequency is the equation for empirical probability. An example, a travel agent determines that in every 50 reservations she makes, 12 will be for a cruise. We know that's going to be about 12 over 50, or about a quarter, about 0.24 to be more precise. The law of large numbers tells us that as an experiment is repeated over and over, the more times we do it, that is, the closer that the empirical probability will be to the theoretical probability of classical probability. So for instance, it's possible that somebody could flip a coin 20 times. In a coin, of course, you have a 50-50 chance of getting heads or tails. But it is possible that within a set of 20 experiments, you only get 3 heads, which would be a very unusual outcome. So the empirical probability would be 3 over 20 in that case. That, of course, is very far from the theoretical probability of 1 out of 2. But if we were to continue this experiment, say, 1,000 times, it's quite likely that we would approach something that looked like 1 over 2. We can also calculate probabilities for frequency distributions, such as in this example, where we've got students' ages listed here in the frequency table. And so we could ask, what is the probability of a student being between the ages of 26 and 33? You see that there are 8 students who fall within that class, and that there are a total 30 students. So the probability, the outcome, the event is 8, and the space is 30. So that would be 0.267, would be the probability. Subjective probability is less mathematical. This has to do with intuition, educated guesses, and estimates. And hopefully, if somebody's an expert, their subjective probability would perhaps be somewhat accurate. And that means it would approach the theoretical probability. So if a business analyst predicts the probability of a union going on strike is 0.15, that business analyst probably has a lot of experience, hopefully, with dealing with unions and so forth. Of course, the real danger is that people who don't have experience or knowledge of classical or experimental probability would use their intuition and arrive at really bad conclusions, such as gambler's logic, which is a good example of subjective probability gone awry. So a range of probabilities rule, which is the range of possibilities when it comes to a probability, is that it ranges from 0 to 1, where 0 is it's impossible, and 1 is it's completely certain. And of course, in the middle there, we've got the 50-50 chance, and then everything in between those extremes. Another important concept, as we've already talked about events, is the kind of negation of that, the complementary events. So for a given sample space, that is the range of outcomes that could occur, in addition to the events are all the events that didn't happen. So if we're rolling a 5 on a die, we know the odds are 1 out of 6. But what are the odds of not rolling a 5 on a die? It would be 1, 2, 3, 4, or 6, and that would be 5 out of 6. The example here is chips. You have 5 red, 4 blue, and 6 white chips in a basket. The probability of selecting a chip that is not blue, well, first we have to know the probability of selecting a blue chip, and we have to know the sample space, which is 15. So if we take 4 over 15, we know the probability of selecting a blue chip is 0.267, and therefore the complementary event, not selecting a blue chip, is going to be 1 minus that probability, or 0.733.